Sounds like these can often be heard on the mountains of La Gomera. But the islanders aren't just whistling for fun, they are communicating with one another across great distances.
What? To be honest, I haven't understood anything. But that makes me sort of curious, because that's the way how people can communicate over here. Unbelievable, I think, but a good reason to listen a little bit closer.
Eugenio Darias has been teaching the whistled language for some time. I set out with him to discover the secret of the Silbo Gomero among the steep volcanic slopes and the deep ravines. La Gomera is the second smallest of Spain's Canary Islands, an archipelago in the Atlantic, some 1500 kilometers from the Spanish mainland. The island is thinly populated with a scattering of little mountain villages. An estimated 20,000 people know the whistled language. It originated among the peaks reaching up to 1,500 meters high. Eugenio Darias is known as one of the island's most experienced whistlers.
Toda esta parte por aquí era de mi abuelo. Nosotros veníamos aquí con los animales. Con los animales veníamos. Todo esto antes era, todo era a base de silbo. Nosotros siempre nos comunicábamos a base de... Aquí en La Gomera existe el silbo por la orografía que tiene la isla. La isla es muy difícil de caminar porque hay mucho barranco. Y entonces, pues claro, nosotros con el silbo lo que hacíamos era ahorrar trabajo. O sea, no teníamos que venir caminando desde aquella montaña, caminando hacia abajo para hablar contigo y luego otra vez a mirar hacia arriba, sino con el silbo desde arriba hubiese desaparecido.
For that, you need to be able to whistle through your fingers. Otherwise, you can't produce sounds loud enough to be heard over in the next valley. But this proves to be a challenge for me.
Exactamente, eso es. Eso es. Así.
Silbo masters can make themselves understood at distances up to 3 kilometers. For a while, because of mobile phones, the whistle's language seemed doomed to extinction. Yet today, young people like Julián Hernández Mora have rediscovered it for themselves.
Para mí es importante el silbo porque es parte de nuestro legado, de nuestra cultura. El silbo forma parte activa de nuestro ser. Yo aprendí a silbar desde que tenía apenas 6 años. He crecido con el silbo y allá donde voy, llevar el silbo gomero en mis venas es algo muy importante.
It's time for me to try. Whoa, it's impossible. I just can't. No one can hear me. I can't hear anyone. And I feel a little bit dizzy. I need a teacher. So I set off for San Sebastián de la Gomera, the capital of the island with a population of just over 9,000. But I don't have much time to take in the sights. I have to go to school.
The special thing about Silbo Gomero is that it is even taught as a compulsory subject in schools here. That's unique in Europe and my chance.
So I'm back in the classroom. My one-on-one lessons begin with a proper greeting. Since 1999, all school children of La Gomera have had to learn silbo. Here, 1 hour of whistling lessons per week is compulsory in grade school.
Lo mismo que decimos hablando, lo decimos silbando. Por ejemplo, mi nombre, Francisco. ¿Lo puedo decir hablando, Francisco o silbando? Podemos silbar en español o podemos silbar en cualquier lengua. Por ejemplo, en alemán, buenos días.
Guten Tag.
The theory of Silbo Gomero is not all that hard. All sounds of Spanish have been condensed into a few whistled notes, two notes for vowels and four for consonants. You clear up any confusion by varying pitch, duration, or simply by the context.
Una vocal grave que sería la A. Que. Ye. Y che. Entonces, desde que yo entré, lo que le hemos transmitido a los niños es que sí es un patrimonio que estamos recuperando, pero sobre todo es parte de ellos mismos. Es parte de su vida, porque sus abuelos, sus bisabuelos silbaron, sus padres aprendieron a silbar o no, pero también a ellos les identifica.
In 2009, UNESCO declared Silbo Gomero an intangible world heritage. A sculpture commemorates this special tradition and inspires me to give it one more try.
Okay, it's much more difficult than I expected to communicate only by whistling, but it's very fascinating to listen to this old tradition, at least as fascinating as the landscape in which Silbo Gomero was born.